6. Hopefully all will be fine. This is our online first class of mathematics, and the topic which I have mentioned here is average speed. And as you know, we have discussed speed in our last class, and now the topic is related to speed, that is average speed. And I have written here the formula for the average speed. As you know, in the speed formula we know it, speed is equal to distance upon time, and here the average speed is there, so we will use only the total distance divided by total time. This is the main difference between the when you are calculating average speed, and if you are finding out the speed only, so you will use the formula distance upon time, and if you are finding the average speed, so you will use that formula, which is total distance upon total time. Alright, now I have given you the another question which is given in your textbook on page number 154, and the question is, I'm going to read it and I'm going to explain. A ship traveled the first part of a journey in 2 hours. It traveled the remaining 90 km of the journey at an average speed of 30 km per hour. The total distance traveled by the ship was 162 km. As I have mentioned here, the total distance of the ship is 162 km. And then find the average speed of the ship for the whole journey. And here see, they are mentioning you the two times. Why? In two hours is given to you in first part, and then the 90 km of an average speed is given to you is 30 km per hour, and distance is 90 km. Are you seeing in this the time is not given to you? Alright? So we can say time we have to find out first for this part. And here you are seeing this time is 2 hours. So as you know, in average speed, our requirement is for finding the total time first, and then we will find out the formula by the help of formula average speed. So what you will do, as you know, speed is equal to distance upon time, and if we are just finding out the time, so as I told you here, it is going to be divided. When you shift it to the other side, it will be multiplied. So time is going to come here, and speed here multiplied when going to the other side, it will become divided. So the formula for the time is distance upon speed. And here you know it, speed is given to you 30 km per hour. Kilometer per hour is the unit of speed, and 90 kilometer is the unit of distance. Alright. Now what will we do? 90 divided by 30. So what it will become, as you know, I told you, you have to cut the zeros. If the two zeros are going to be cut, now in a table of 3, 9 is coming. So what you will do, 3 ones are 3 and 3 threes are 9. So what the time is now? 3 hours. Now what will you do? You have to find out the total time. So you will add this, which is given to you in 2 hours, and the next time which we have find out here is 3. So it will become 5 hours. Alright? And you will do this question in book because the spaces are there and you can solve it on book. Okay, now the average speed, for the average speed you will use the total distance, which is 162, and divided by the total time which you have find out here is divided by 5. Now in a rougher you will just divide this and then find the average speed easily. Alright, so I am going to just divide it. 5 threes are 15, and then minus 1, 2 is going to down, and it will become 12, then 5 twos are 10, and then subtract, you can put the decimal and 0, so it will become 5 fours are 20. Now see, the average speed which you have here find out is 32.4, and what is the unit? Kilometer per hour. Alright, so this is the answer of average speed if you have to give it the distance and time. I hope you understand this question, and you will just revise it and go through it, see it from the book, and here I have explained you, and inshallah in next class I will explain you the next thing. Alright, take care.